what a couple of semi-finals we've just witnessed. First, the men's singles, our third match of the day, and then that second women's singles, both going the full distance, both absolute thrillers. So just one more semi-final to come, and it's men's doubles, and it features Lu Cheng Yao and the left-handed Yang Po Han of Chinese Taipei, beaten finalists a couple of weeks ago in Lucknow at the Said Modi Grand Prix Gold. And they're up against Beri Anggriawan and Hadianto, an Indonesian pair who won the first Grand Prix Gold event of the year, the Malaysian Masters in Cebu. So this should be a great match here, this men's doubles. Well, as far as the men's doubles draw is concerned, we're obviously concentrating on the top half of the draw, because you can see in the bottom half of the draw that semi-final already completed. Wang Kaixiang and Wang Yilu beating the home players there. But there were six different nations involved at quarter-final stage, only four seeds, no seeds in the top half of the draw. All four pairs in the bottom half, although it's not shown there, at quarter-final stage were seeded. So four different nations involved at semi-final stage. One of the finalists has already been decided. We're about to find out who will join Wang Kaixiang and Wang Yilu in tomorrow's final. Will it be Lu Cheng Yao and Yang Po Han, or will it be Beri Anggriawan and his partner Hadianto? So the left and right-handed combination from Chinese Taipei. The left-hander Yang Po Han and his taller partner Lu Cheng Yao. They've both had a very good tournament here. They were both in quarterfinals of mixed doubles yesterday. So they're trying to make it through to back-to-back Grand Prix Gold tournament finals, having been in the final 2 weeks ago in Lucknow. Not seeded as a pair. Well, then nor are their opponents. Look how tall he is. He's towering over the court officials, Lu Cheng Yao.
And please welcome Beri Anggriawan and Hadianto from Indonesia.
Led out by Beri Anggriawan and his partner Hadianto. Only their third ever tournament together for the Indonesians, and this is their third semi-final. What a great start to a partnership. Three tournaments, three semi-finals at least. Because as I was mentioning, they won their first tournament together, the Malaysian Masters.
Umpire, Sudaphat Lepon Kunrat from Thailand. Service judge, Wanpaya Asing Samanan from Thailand.
Both are court officials from the host nation.
Lu Cheng Yao and Yang Po Han from Chinese Taipei. Beri Anggriawan and Hadianto from Indonesia.
Well, the first duty of the umpire, the toss of the coin. So the Indonesians have won the toss. I'm still none the wiser as to what they chose. Whether they chose ends or whether they chose to serve or receive. But two pairs that we know are in extremely good form. And two pairs, one pair from Indonesia that is extremely new. This is only their third tournament together, as I say. And this time last year, the pair from Chinese Taipei hadn't formed their partnership, because they only formed their partnership last July. So there is the left-handed Yang Po Han. He is 22 years of age, not 20, as shown there. He's going to turn 23 next month. Born in Taipei City, he was telling me 2 weeks ago. Fire! 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 He's a tall man, is Lu Qingyao. He's 23 years of age. They're at a career high, 24 in the world ranking, enjoying their second week at a career high. And as far as their matches so far are concerned, well, they had a tough quarter final against two Chinese players who played against each other in the final of the World Championships in Jakarta in 2015 in the mixed doubles event, Liu Cheng and Jiang Nan. Had to save two game points in the opening game there. Now that was never 2 minutes warm up. Haven't had time to look at all our players on court. There's Berry Angriawan, 25 years of age, not 26, from Sukabumi in West Java. They are currently 100s in the world ranking, but then they've only got two tournaments towards that world ranking. Ardianto will turn 24 next month, so he's 23 at the moment. And he was born in Cilacap in Central Java. Now they've beaten a seeded pair, and it certainly wasn't an all-Indonesian pair. It was a mixed nationality pair in the second round, the number five seeds. Hendra Setiawan from Indonesia and Tambu Hyung of Malaysia. Now these two pairs did meet each other in the semi-final stage 2 weeks ago in Lucknow. And obviously with Lu and Yang getting through to the final, they won on that occasion. It was two straight games, as you can see.
Yang Bohang, Chinese Taipei. And on my left, Murray Akinwat and Hanido. Murray Akinwat, he served to Lu Xiangyao. Love all, play.
So Berry Angriawan and his partner Ardianto, far side of the court, getting the semi-final
one
underway.
Love.
Oops, confusion. Now don't be surprised to see these two players from Chinese Taipei hurling themselves around the court. They're an exciting, dynamic pair. The little left-hander is a very busy player on court. It's a great character too. Very trendy hairstyle, a little bit of body art as well. He's a great character. Oh, missed it. Well, Berry Angriawan, there he is. Is winner of four Grand Prix gold titles with three different partners in the men's doubles.
Oh. Service over. 3-2.
A very successful partnership with Ricky Suwadi. In fact, they didn't win a Grand Prix Gold tournament. They lost in the final of the London Grand Prix Gold of 2013. But Rian Agunsoputro, his other partner, with which he's won
two
Grand Prix Gold titles. He's a big man to hurl himself around the court. Lu Qingyao, 1 meter 90, that's about 6'3". Service error there from Ardianto. Mariona Meranats, the Indonesian coach. Opportunity.
Sorry.
Yeah, he knows it.
4-5.
it's a good start by the Indonesians, very positive. I did think 2 weeks ago in Lucknow, I watched their semi-final, and I did think that the Indonesian pair were looking a little fatigued after winning the Malaysian Masters the week before in Cebu. Looking far more alert here in Bangkok. Yeah, well worked. Well, the left and right handed combination. Set play. Straight smash from Wu Ching Yao. You know, it was very funny last week during the final, last week, 2 weeks ago in Lucknow, because Wu Ching Yao obviously has on his back Lu, which is the family name, and then just initials for Ching Yao. And the umpire actually called him over to have a word with him and called him Lucy, because that, of course, is what the initials spell on the back of the shirt.
Sorry, Sorrow. Sorry, Sorrow. 9-6.
Service fault called. Racket not pointing in a downward direction. Throws heart and soul into it, doesn't he? Look, the left-hander. He's great to watch. Really is. Yeah. They really show their emotions on court as well. I'm sure all the coaches out there will be saying you shouldn't be doing that, but as a fan and as a spectator, I love to see it. Love to see the players sharing their emotions with us, the spectators.
9-0.
Share in the elation, share in the disappointment. We can all empathize. Attack, and when they're using this right-handed formation play, this pair from Chinese Taipei really is very, very impressive. In the end, the Bing Ban. That's the problem with the taller players. It's great for their reach and their smashing ability, but when you play the shuttle fast into the body, that's when they struggle to get out of the way and give themselves the freedom to play the shot.
Play.
Rally, but it is Lu and Yang who have the advantage at the mid-game interval. Look where his base position is. Lu Qingyao way back, almost on the double service line earlier on in that rally. Ariono definitely saying something about the angled shots. Maybe a little more variation in pace, variation in angle, that's what he's after. Oh, he can't afford to hit towards his forehand side. Young Pohan will pounce on it. Both left it for the other. Yeah, it's good placement by the Indonesians. Yeah, he's absolutely looking for that. And it just seems that it's an automatic shot from Hardianto to try and play down to what is normally a player's backhand side. He's got to remember that Young Pohan is a left-hander. Yeah. So quick, so hunting the shuttle. Did he intercept that? One, and then round the head. Oh, that's amazing. So quick. Placement. Yeah, it's got to be a steeper angle against the left-hander because he uses this crouch defense position, which means anything there he is, crouch defense. So anything that's flat, he will pounce upon. If you get the angle, because his racket is held high, he's in all sorts of trouble. As long. Good serve. overdone it. So often in men's doubles we see these short rallies. So much pressure and emphasis on the serve, return and third shot. And that tends to set the tone for the rally. Yeah, that's clever. Nice play from Hardianto. Just 1 point in it.
Play.
Away from this opening game. And just in case you were wondering what all the raucous noise was about, Super Jurakun and Tera Banachai lost in their women's doubles semi-final. So four home players in finals tomorrow. Well, it's game point opportunity now for Yu Qing Yao and Yang Po Han. Totally misjudged the return, Hardianto, and the opening game, 21-16 in favour of the pair from Taipei, Lu Qing Yao and Yang Po Han. Only 16 minutes needed for that opening game, 21-16. Ago they didn't have a coach with them either. I've got a coach here this week, Lu and Yang. So the umpire calls for the players to get ready and to start the second game. Wu Qingyao and Yang Pohan having taken the first, 21-16. What can the Indonesians do in response? Defense, I like that. Yep, that's a good call. It was in.
Well,
it was never a dull moment when this pair from Taipei are playing. Perfect placement of the smash, isn't it? Aim towards the right side of the body, between the right shoulder and the right hip. Very difficult for a right-hander to defend that. In fine voice, aren't they? Say, I do like the development path of this new pair from Taipei. Wu Qingyao and Yang Pohan, as I was mentioning, they only formed their partnership in July last year at the Vietnam Grand Prix. They then played international challenger events, one in Belgium, one in Poland, one in Prague, reached the final in Malaysia at the international challenger event there. So four finals last year. Get used to winning, get used to playing all days of the tournament. And now this year, at the beginning of this year, they're finding success at Grand Prix gold level. So gone up a tier of tournaments. Oh, that's brilliant, absolutely brilliant. Backhand defense from Yang Pohan. Blocked cross court and immediately followed forward. Four straight points now. 4-2-3 down. There's a couple of errors he's made on the return of Saif. Hardianto. Thank you. think it's six straight points. Comes to an end. Arianto played the last couple of years with Harianto. Of two titles from four finals, won the Vietnam International Series and Polish International as well. So he too has had a very grounded and well-planned career development path. Very angry, without any question, the most experienced player on court. Crikey, what on earth happened there? Broke the strings of his racket? What happened? Yeah.
Ready.
Because this bounces before it's got to the front court, I think. Yeah. Well, it bounced under the net anyway. That's the problem when the strings go. From Angria One, a young man who preferred volleyball when he was a small boy, and he was encouraged by his father to play badminton because there was a badminton court in front of their house. And we're jolly lucky that that wasn't encouraged, because he's a great player, fine player to watch.
11-6.
There's just too much defending from the Indonesians at the moment. 5-point advantage to Lu Qingyao and Yang Pohan here at the mid-game interval of the second game. No, I don't think Barry Angria would have been tall enough to be a volleyball player. And 178, that's 5'10". Which for volleyball players I think is relatively short. No, just as well he chose badminton. Was a nice idea, just guiding that push into the open space, but obviously no good if it doesn't go over. Oh, that's super. Super play
sorry,
from Andrea One.
And for Wolf. Ready. Thank you. Ready.
Yeah, well, the umpire saying, come on, get ready. That defensive shot that he tried before, that time it worked, but they made an error on the next one.
9-13.
Particularly like celebrations when your opponents make an error, but no question in my mind, it's the pair from Taipei who are more fired up for this semi-final. I've been very generous about the amount of timeouts these players can have. Brilliant. Wonderful combination play from Lu and Yang. You'd think they'd won the match already with those celebrations, wouldn't you? Double hit. Good spot by the umpire.
Sorry, scorer. 12-16.
every point won celebrated as they inch closer and closer to back-to-back Grand Prix Gold Tournament Finals. Problem is for the Indonesians, they're really forced into lifting because young Pohan is so fast to come forward. Look, you don't block it back to the net, which is what they probably usually do, because they know that he's going to intercept. So you lift it, and you lift it to the tall man, Wu Qingyao, and that's what happens. Great control from Hardianto.
14,
my goodness 18. Me, a beautiful low serve. Great racket head control on the third shot. Change of shuttle, change of racket as well, I think, for Lu Qingyao.
18.
Yeah, just wants to try out the new racket. Courtesy amongst the players. Closing down this 15, deficit are the Indonesian pair. Yeah, put away with venom. There's no way that was coming back. Down. Get up! Well, no lack of effort, no lack of drama. Look at that. Oh, we got wheel spin. Look as he tries to get up. Yeah, slips on his own perspiration again. I told you they're fun to watch.
Thank you.
Just 2 points the deficit. wasn't the best of serves. Yeah, and from that moment, they were always under pressure, the Indonesians. And now it's three match point opportunities for Nguyen Yang.
Play.
Good serve. It's going wide. Yeah, it's back-to-back Grand Prix Gold Tournament finals for Lu Qingyao and Yang Po Han of Chinese Taipei. Second consecutive Grand Prix Gold that they've reached the final, and in doing so have beaten Berry Angriawan and Hardianto in the semi-final stage. Would you believe it? It's the exact same scoreline as 2 weeks ago in the semi-final in Lucknow. 21-16, 21-17. A little quicker here in Bangkok. 39 minutes, it took 43 minutes in Lucknow. But 21-16, 21-17. Oh. Pretty certain their ranking will go up even further. They're already at a career high. There's confirmation of how they're through to their second Grand Prix Gold Tournament final. Consecutive events, 2 weeks apart, of course. So that brings to a conclusion semi-finals day here in Bangkok, and it all started with home success in the mixed doubles, because Pua Varanukro and Teirat Tanachai won in two straight games against Terry He and Tan Wei Han. And then it was women's singles, and the home fans were hoping for an all Thailand women's singles final, but it wasn't to be, because the left-handed Hori from Japan spoiled that ambition of the home fans, winning in two straight games. She obviously likes playing here in Thailand, because she won the Thailand Open last year, Hori. Then it was men's singles, and what joy for Wang Jialun from Thailand. The battle of the bronze medalists from last year's World Junior Championships, both 18 years of age, and what a match it was. An hour and 7 minutes before he eventually won 22-20 in that deciding game. Then it was the second of the women's singles semi-finals, and Busanan Ongbangrangpan had to come back from the brink. She was a game and match point down at 19-20 in the second game. She eventually won, as you can see, 22-20 that second game, and 21-17 in the decider. That was an hour and 19 minutes. And as we've just seen in the men's doubles, Lu Qingyao and Yang Po Han are through to a second Grand Prix Gold final in 2 weeks. So that's it for semi-finals day. Finals tomorrow, same time as today. That's 1 p.m. local time. That's 0600 GMT from all of us here in Bangkok. Until tomorrow, bye for now.